Thank you. speak without the microphone?
Yes.
Awesome. Thank you very much for having us here. It's wonderful to see all of you here in your beautiful concert hall. We're delighted to be a part of the Walker Series. And welcome to our program, Faith in the Seed. This program was designed musically by us based on one of Henry David Thoreau's last writings called Dispersion of Seeds, in which he explored and essentially discovered that seeds were traveled throughout the world and taken by wind, animals, and water. And he, of course, had to be a philosopher as well as a naturalist, and likened those things to the human condition and what humans do with a seed and how it grows. And so musically speaking, what we did this evening is we started our program with what you just heard, which was a Buxtehude sonata trio by Buxtehude, originally written for gamba, keyboards, and violin in pre-Baroque times. And Buxtehude himself was a great gambist, and you can tell by how busy Derry was during that piece. Generally speaking, Baroque music and cellists are kind of just laying low there, just playing not much melody and not much meat. But he had lots to do, and that's thanks in part because Buxtehude was also a very fine cellist. And so you can see that the writing is on the wall. Hopefully by the end of our program, you'll see that this little start of piano trio in its earliest form evolves into some really phenomenal stuff.
We're having a lot of fun. Henry David Thoreau wrote in his treatise on the dispersion of seeds, though I do not believe that a plant will spring up where no seed has been, I have great faith in a seed. Convince me that you have a seed there, and I am prepared to expect wonders. In Henry David Thoreau's time, a lot of people thought that plants sprung up without any seed at all. They had spontaneous combustion, as it were. If a grove of trees suddenly started growing a mile away from similar trees, they thought it was just providence of some kind. Henry David Thoreau himself didn't believe that was possible. And in fact, he follows seeds in his boat or wading through water, tracking animals to see where they landed. And he made a note that he would come back later to see what grew there. He was one of the first scientists in the field of botany, and he kept very detailed notes, many of which we still refer to today. If in our program, Buxtehude's trio sonata was the seed, then we can trace that seed through Bach, who was a great admirer of Buxtehude. Bach wrote many trio sonatas himself, and that influenced Haydn and several others in the classical period. And Haydn himself sort of put together what we now consider the genre of the piano trio, basically a violin, a cello, and a piano playing independent parts that work together very beautifully. And then Beethoven picked that up and eventually passed that to Mendelssohn. So if Buxtehude is the seed, Mendelssohn is the mature tree. It's a wonderful, beautiful, lush, romantic piece. It's in four movements. The first movement is a very energetic, fast piece. The second movement, in contrast, is a very lyrical, almost a lullaby or a love song. The third movement is a very sprightly scherzo, very Mendelssohnian. And the last movement starts with a very rollicking theme in the cello, of course, but builds to a climax in what we consider part of the faith theme in this as well. He creates a climax with a hymn tune, with a chorale, much like Bach would have done. Mendelssohn was a great admirer of Bach. So please enjoy the fruits of Buxtehude's Seed, the Mendelssohn Piano Trio No. 2 in C minor.